Okay, so let's look at the working of the PN junction diode. First, we will look at the case of unbiased. Okay, means you will not apply any source to the terminals of the diodes. You are not applying any voltage source. Okay, and these are the representations. So this unfilled hole, this circle will be represented as holes. These circle with negative sign inside is acceptor ion. This filled circle is electron, and this circle with positive sign is donor ion. Okay, so this is how the diode will look like if you try to merge P and N set type semiconductor, so that we will make a PN junction diode. Okay, now when you have P and N junction connected to each other, P has holes, majority carrier, okay, and it consists of, each hole is attached with acceptor ion. Okay, during the process of making P-type semiconductor, these acceptor ions will appear. Okay, so that's how the P-type is. I am ignoring the minority carriers, that is electrons, here for the better understanding. Okay, there will be some few amounts of electrons available in this P section, okay, which I am not showing, just for the clarity. Similarly, here in N side, during the process of making N type semiconductor, this positive signs will appear. Each electron is having positive sign, okay, attached to it, that positive circle. This is nothing but the donor ion. Okay, during the process of making N type semiconductor, you will dope it with the donor type of atoms. Okay, so from that concept, it will come out the positive charges, and each electron is carrying positive ion, you can see. Okay, so they are a set, hole and acceptor ion, electron and donor ion. Okay, so that's how the n-type and p-type semiconductor will look like. But when you merge it, what will happen? This is the scenario at t is equal to 0. These are the metal contacts, okay, and these are the wires. Now what will happen at t is equal to t1? Let's say this is the equilibrium time, means after this there will be no process happening in this unbiased PN junction. So what will happen? The electron will try to combine with hole, or you can say hole will try to combine with electron. Okay, what will happen then? You see three columns are there, and here only two columns are there. One column is merged, so this hole is combined with this electron, this hole is combined with this electron, this hole is combined with this electron, and they disappeared. Okay, because they made bond. Now only left thing was negatives and positive ions. Okay, these two guys, acceptor ions and donor ions. But now they will not be called as acceptor ion, donor ions. They will be called as immobile ions. Okay, because they can't move on their own. The carriers were electron and holes. They are gone now. They made their bonds and they left negative and positive ions. Okay, now they are called as immobile ions. Okay, and if you will see, this dotted line is the same as this line. Okay, this line. So what is happening here? Rest of everything is same. Two columns are same, two columns are same. So this is to give you a picture that what happened in this time. Okay, some electrons and some holes merged each other, made a bond, and they disappeared, leaving negatives and positive near the junction. This is the junction. Okay, dotted line is the junction. That's how PN junction is made. Now what is the properties? You can see this positive, this is the positive half, and this is the negative half of between these two lines. Okay, so what is happening? Positive, this is positive and this is negative, they will give a barrier potential. Okay, this is V0, which is called as barrier potential. Why this is called a barrier potential? Because they will act as a barrier. See, I am showing only one column, one column merged. There will be many columns getting merged together. So more number of negatives will be there, more number of positives will be there. Okay, so what will happen? They will generate an electric field in this direction, positive to negative. And the flow, they will oppose the flow of the electrons and holes which are trying to combine this electric field generating due to immobile charge. Okay, so they are opposing their call, means whatever was happening, slowly when the electric field strength will become very high, means more number of positive will appear, more number of negatives will appear, then electric field will become higher, means it will be of great value, which can counter the flow of this electrons and holes coming towards the junction. Okay, so E opposes the further flow of carrier after some time. Okay, when the electric field strength has become means significant. Okay, they will restrict the flow of electron holes, and at some point equilibrium condition is reached, means the electric field is so insignificant that there is no further flow of electrons and holes towards the junction, and that is the structure you will get, this kind of. Okay, so that is the reason you are calling it as barrier potential, because it is acting as a barrier for further flow of carriers. Okay, these are immobile ions, this is the equilibrium for unbiased case. Now V naught is given as Vt, which is thermal equivalent of temperature, ln log base E Na Nd divided by Ni square. Okay, where Na is acceptor concentration, Nd is donor concentration, and Ni square is intrinsic concentration. Okay, this you might be knowing. This is the value of this voltage. This will be almost around 0.3 or 0.7 volts range of this value. Okay, it will be very small. So I hope it is clear that when you merge a p and n semiconductor, what will happen at equilibrium. Mind you, I have not applied any forward bias or reverse bias till now. It is just an open circuit, there is no biasing around. So what we got is this kind of scenario. Now we will see what will happen if you will apply forward voltage and reverse voltage. Okay.